If you want to send out an Airtable form with information already filled out inside of the form, look no further than this video. We're going to be diving into everything there is to know about pre-filling a form in Airtable. So if that's of interest, stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth. I own Gap Consulting, where I help save you over 20 hours of your time every week with no code and automation. At the forefront of this is Airtable. So what we're talking about here today is super relevant to the conversation because we're going to be pre-filling forms and saving you a ton of time on the back end through some formula magic. But before I get into it, I want to invite you to join me for my Airtable automation training. In this free training, I will teach you the basic building blocks behind automation, both in Airtable and out of it in other environments. So if you want to start automating your repetitive tasks and reclaiming your time, look no further than this training. Check it out at garethpronovost.com/webinar-registration. I'll include the links below. But without further ado, let's hop into my screen and get to the heart of this video. Now to get started, we have to start looking at our overall data structure. And the good news is it's really simple in our example. We have two tables here, contacts and forms. In our contacts table, we're storing contact information. So in this case, a first name and a company name. I then have a linked relationship to my form submission that's going to occur in this next table. And I'm also running a formula here that's combining the first name and the company. So in this case, Gareth at Gap Consulting is the formula output because I have the first name and the company name here. Now we also bring in our record ID and you'll see why in just a moment. Let's flip on now over to the forms table. And in this table, if we were to create a new record that's not necessarily submitted through a form, you'll see that we're capturing that date time received. So this particular field is the created time field, and this is capturing the metadata of when a record comes into existence. Of course, when someone submits the form, ideally it would then be linked to a contact as well. And here are the questions that we're going to ask them. So what is your favorite color? We have two options here. And then what's your favorite sport? Let's suppose hockey. So here you see, we then also have a form ID where we're bringing in or concatenating the contact information with the date of when the submission was received. In this case, March 5th. So let's talk about pre-filling this form. We have a couple of different forms built. And the first thing you want to know is that a form in Airtable only has one function, and it is to create a new record in one table and one table only. In this case, if I wanted to ask people to fill out contact information, I would need a unique form for that. And then separately, another form that asks them for their favorite color and their favorite sport, linking back to their contact information. So let's start with our contacts. And you'll see we have a very simple new contact form in Airtable. When we start with a brand new form, all of the independent fields within our table will be listed on the form. In this case, that includes any fields that do not include formulas or roll-up fields or those more complicated dependent variables. So for us, we have a first name, a company name, and our link to forms. In our example, it doesn't make a lot of sense for us to include this link to forms in this particular form because we just want to collect contact info. So I would probably remove that field so that we just have the first name and the company name. You might also make some other changes here like add a submit new response button or show a blank form, whatever settings you want. The point is we want to be able to pre-fill this form. If we just go to this open form right here, you're going to see that yes, it just has the live already created version of this form, but none of the information is already filled out. And maybe you already know somebody's first name, but you don't know their company name, and you want to fill out some of that information for them. That's where a pre-fill form is going to come into play. So the first thing to take here with this pre-fill form is the actual form URL. This form URL is pre-generated for you by Airtable when you create the form. You can reset it or change the URL, but you don't have control to edit it. You can't make it something specific. Now, in order to pre-fill some of this information, the first thing we have to determine is which of these fields do we want to pre-fill. Let's say we wanted to pre-fill the first name. This is pretty easy. We simply, at the end of the form URL, start with a question mark. After this, we will put in pre-fill and underscore. Question mark pre-fill underscore is telling Airtable that we are ready to pre-fill a field, but we haven't told it what that field is yet. In this case, let's say we wanted to pre-fill first name. The way to do this is to actually type out the name of the field as it shows up, and any place that you have a space, you need to replace the space with a plus. Then after this, include that equal sign. So again, looking at these broken down elements, we've included the field name here of first name, and where we had a space in our field name, we replaced it with a plus. After that, we have the equal sign, and this is where we're going to tell Airtable what that first name is. Let's suppose that we were sending a form to one of our friends named Joseph. We would simply type in Joseph now, and this fully completed URL, if we go to this URL, if we hit enter and we visit this, you're going to see that Joseph is automatically filled out or pre-filled in our first name field. So far, so good. We are halfway there. Now, if we had some other information, maybe we already knew Joseph's company name as well, and we simply wanted him to confirm this information before submitting it, well, we could fill that out also. Now, the difference here is because we've already started with the pre-fill, we already wrote our question mark pre-fill first name, well, now we're not going to follow this up with a question mark. Instead, we're going to bring in an ampersand. So we're going to say and prefill, all lowercase, underscore. Again, we're setting Airtable up to know that we're prefilling another field. In this case, we're prefilling the field called company name. So company name, again, follow the same rules. Anytime you have a space, replace it with a plus. Company name equals, and now we can bring in our company name. In this case, let's say Joseph works at Bricks R Us. Go ahead and fill that out. Again, this is now completed. This second portion here, following the ampersand, is the second prefill. So if I hit enter now, it will fill out that company name for us appropriately. Now, where things get weird is if there's a character that you are trying to prefill with that does not belong in a URL. So for example, let's say Bricks R Us was not all one word, but it had spaces in it. If I put a space here and a space here, well, you would probably assume that this would break because a space does not belong in a URL. So if I were to hit enter here, what we're actually going to see is the way that this form should be written. Go ahead and hit enter, and you'll see that those spaces were replaced with %20s, which is the way that we can communicate a space inside of a URL. Now, if you get stuck and you're not sure what the proper character replacement is, I want to bring your attention to a really handy Airtable formula. Let's hop back into our actual database, and I'm going to unhide a field where I've already created this. If you ever wonder how you would put something into URL terms, because again, you might not know what to do with a space or some other symbol, well, in that case, we can use the encode URL component formula. So whenever you're stuck, just reference the field that you're wondering about. This formula is going to do all the heavy lifting for you on the back end and will tell you exactly how you can encode that little piece so that you can better pre-fill your form. Now for the interesting part. Let's say that we already received this information from Joseph. Joseph from Bricks R Us, he submits his pre-filled information, or maybe instead he makes some changes to that form and submits it. Either way, we collect that information. So here I have the new first name and the company name for this particular individual. Perfect. Now what I want to do is head on over to my forms and ask Joseph these questions. Hey Joseph, what's your favorite color? What's your favorite sport? So how can we work on this form? Well, on this particular form, we're going to have the contact where we link the form submission to the person who's submitting it. We're also going to ask the favorite color, and in this case, it's either blue or red, and we can choose if we want to supply this in a dropdown or in a list because of the fact that this is a single select field. So that gives us some special options given the field type, and I like to see it in a list view. And then we also ask for that favorite sport, and we're asking it in a text field so he can type in whatever he'd like. So this looks pretty good. I like this form. So here are my tips for how you can write a really easy formula inside of Airtable to pre-fill any URL. First things first, I'm going to grab the form URL. You can do that by either going to the form, going to the open published version of the form, or you can simply open share form and copy that form URL right here. Once I get that, I'm going to pop back into my database, and I'm going to actually create one form for each contact. So let's go. I'm going to drop into my contacts, and I'm going to start by just pasting in the form URL that I copied. So here is my questions form, and I'll write a formula here. Inside of my formula, inside of single or double quotations, I'll just paste the form itself and create this field. So any new record that's created here, any new person who joins our list of contacts is going to have the exact same starting point. That is the form URL. Now for step two, where we're going to pre-fill it for each unique individual. And here is where I'm going to add the appending parts to my generic form URL, and I'm going to make it unique for each individual contact. I'm going to do this by creating a formula that appends the form URL with all of the extra pieces of data that we need. So let's start with the contact information. The link to contacts. Again, if we go back to our form, the first question is, who are you? What is the contact? And we don't want them to have to pick from the list of contacts. So if we want to make a change here, the first step is to pre-fill this. Again, we'll use a formula field. I'm going to write a concatenate formula. And this formula is going to allow us to string together multiple other strings. Now, the first piece that I want to use in this formula is, of course, my root, my URL for my form. So I will just reference my questions form here. And if I stop here and I just create this field, all this is going to do for us is show us the form. So nothing is unique about this output yet. But if I want to make the first question unique so that it's filled out already for the contact, I can append, right? So I'll start by putting in a comma to denote that I'm going to bring in another piece now. And this element is going to be static. So this element here is going to be inside of quotations, either single or double. And it's the same thing every time. Question mark, pre-fill, underscore. And now I'm going to tell it what field I want to pre-fill. In this case, contact equals. You'll notice that this is the exact same syntax that I was using before. And then I want this next part to be unique for every instance. In this case, I want it to pre-fill with the record ID of the contact. So let's do that. I'll add a comma to denote that I'm moving into another chunk or another string, and I'm going to reference that record ID formula that I already have right here. You'll notice that every single record in my Airtable database has its own ID. So once I bring this in, this output is now unique. Up until the equal sign here, everything is identical, but then the added record ID is unique in each case. So let's go ahead and click on this part for Joseph. This is the Joseph record here. When I click on this, it's going to open up the form already linked to Joseph. Let's do it again, going back to my database. If I click on the form for Gareth here on the top, it's going to open up a new form that's already linked to Gareth. Pretty cool, but let's say we wanted to add even more stuff. Let's suppose we start by filling out everyone's favorite color as red, and we allow them to make changes if they don't think that red should be filled out. Well, again, we will add some more elements to our pre-fill URL. After the record ID, we will add a comma, and we will add the same syntax that we had before. Now, because this is our second variable, we don't start again with a question mark, but instead we have to start with an ampersand. So ampersand pre-fill underscore. And what is the field that we're pre-filling? Well, again, let's flip back to our form. This time we want to fill out favorite color. I can just copy this, go on back to my formula here. I'll paste that in, but I have to remember anywhere that I have a field that has a space, in the title, I have to replace that space with a plus. Now, you don't want to get confused because anywhere that a field has a space, you're going to replace the space with a plus. But if you're replacing a space in a pre-fill answer, then that's going to be replaced with a %20. In order to tie this up, I need to now include an equal sign after here. And this is where I'm going to need to tell it what I want to pre-fill that with. So in this case, since it's going to be red every time and I'm not going to call upon a different record ID, I'll just fill in red inside of the same quotation marks and I'll save this field up. And now we are going to see that after the unique record ID in every single instance, now we have and prefill underscore favorite color equals red. So if I click on this, again, this one for Joseph, we're going to see that it's already filled out for Joseph. And it's already selected the favorite color red. Of course, Joseph can clear the selection or select blue. Of course, we're inviting him to tell us his favorite sport and he can then submit. So we're good there. Now, the last thing to know about a pre-filled form is that you cannot always remove a field from the form and still have it fill out. So let's go back to our second form here. This is the one where we're asking for the contact information. You might notice that if we provide this form for them, they can look at all of our other contacts, and maybe we don't want to give them that access. In fact, a lot of the times, this is going to be a non-starter for you, so you wouldn't go with this solution. Unless you said, maybe I want to hide that contact. So fantastic, let's go back to our form and actually try to do that. I will hide the contact here. And so now we're just asking for the favorite color and the favorite sport. Let's go back into our contacts, where remember, I have a completed and unique pre-fill form that's going to link back to whoever clicks on this. In this case, this link is for Joseph. So if I click on this link again, we know that in the background, it's pre-filling the contact information for Joseph, as well as pre-filling the color to be red. If I submit this form though, and I go back into my forms database here, and I look at this submission, you're going to see that it was just submitted, but it does not link to that contact. So this is where things break down. Because I hid that element from the form, even though I pre-filled the form to fill it out, it didn't capture that data. Now that being said, there are some incredible third-party form softwares that integrate wonderfully with Airtable, my favorite of those being JotForm. So you can always go into a third-party form that does get this functionality. It's going to be a little more software, maybe a little more cost, but at the end of the day, if it gives you the functionality you need, it's probably worth the investment. In any case, I hope you got a ton of value from this video. If you did and you want to learn more about Airtable, automation, and no code, don't forget to subscribe to the channel. And I will see you in the next one.
As always, I hope you found that to be extremely helpful. If you did and you'd like to learn more, swing by our website and see how we can help. We offer a free Airtable crash course that will help you level up in Airtable quickly. And we also have some paid services, including hourly consultations with our experts. We have some online courses and a group coaching program. And for advanced needs, we can build a bespoke solution for you from scratch. So swing on by, and I look forward to connecting with you soon.